So here we see what's happening here. This is the marginalization matrix that we have. Why is it only active in this area? Well, because we assumed that the stimulus was something like this. Here, we see if we marginalize, which is like literally we add everything to the margin of this matrix, we're gonna get a response distribution here. Now, what do we have? We have the response distribution, which depends on the parameters of the prior. I should add one thing. We will often see discretization artifacts here. Now, like depending on how many rows we use for this matrix, there will be only so many values of what choices are to be taken. And therefore, this response distribution in practice will often look jagged. We can make it go be less jagged by just grading this more finely. So now that we can calculate the response distribution, now we are back in the area where we know exactly what we should do, which is we need to calculate the goodness of fit. In this case, it can be the log likelihood. We calculate the probability of x hat given x for the parameters that we hypothesized. We then observe subjects' choices. So we have pairs, what we showed and what they chose. And we will assume independence, and then we will get that the log of the probability of the data given the parameters of our model is the sum over all the trials of the log of the probability of the choice in trial I given the stimulus in trial I. Now this is of course something that we could optimize, and with that we can evaluate how good a model with given parameters are. Now I want to have a quick aside here. When we fit models, it's always important to simulate data to see if we can recover the parameters from that simulation. Because if we make mistakes in coding, and we always do, or at least I always do, this is the only way to be halfway sure that there's not major bugs lurking in the code. Now, normally what we would do at this point of time, we would fit. We call a function that calculates the log of the probability as a function of the model parameters. And then we use an optimizer to find the best values. And then we can compare the values with the values that we generated. Now in our case, we only want to look at a single parameter, which is the probability that there's a common cause. So instead of going the fitting route, we already provide you with code that will basically try all meaningful parameters for this constant of how important the common versus the independent mode is in the mixture of Gaussian's models. So why don't you? So now you can use the plot my Bayes model function that already does all that to loop through all meaningful parameters to see if we will recover the right one.